I go anywhere, anywhere with you, 'cause you fill my mind, oh, you fill my mind. We could build a dream, start up something new, let the old be dead, let the shadows be my head. When the world is on your shoulders and you feel like falling over, just come a little closer, I'll be there for you, I'll be there for you. 'Cause when we are together, I know you feel the tension, just let me in your head so I can be there for you, there for you. The night is young, won't you sing for me, won't you sing for me.
Okay, hey guys, Harsh here and welcome back to Technoloop. Today, let's talk about Instagram. Yes, the social media that is currently the best according to me. I don't like Facebook, I don't like Snapchat, I barely use Google+, and Instagram is the one we all use. It's the one we all love, and that's why let's talk about how to upload better pictures on Instagram in this video today. Without wasting any more time, let's begin. By the way, I changed my clothes. It was way too hot to wear a shirt. That's why I'm back in a t-shirt. It feels cool, it looks cool, and let's get to the point. Okay, today I'm gonna talk about what I have learned on this journey of Instagram. I've made a lot of mistakes when it comes to Instagram. I've uploaded photos which look really bad, and that's why I wanted to share my experience with you guys. Whatever I have learned, I will share that with you today. First and foremost, do not use letterboxes on your photos. So for example, this is a letterbox, and do not use that on your photos because it doesn't look good. Now I know that Instagram has resolution limits. That means you can upload photos. Wait, someone is at the door. I'll be right back. It was my sister. Okay, so I was talking about letterboxes. Do not use letterboxes on your photos. I know that Instagram has resolution limits. That means you can upload photos up to a particular resolution, and some people want their some people want to upload their full photos, like they want to upload the full frame. It may be a wide screen or it may be a tall photo, and Instagram does not allow that. It crops the photo. I know that in that scenario you can use letterboxes, but make sure that you use letterboxes for all your photos then. So for example, this profile right here, this profile of Ash Taylor, it looks really good. Ash over here is a cinematographer and he puts up his frames, and that's why he uses white letterboxes throughout all of his photos, and this profile looks very, very clean. I personally have used letterboxes and they do not look good in like somewhere in the between. That's why use them for all your photos or don't use them at all. Okay, now second point that I have learned is that always edit your photos, and that is a very big point. Some people out there might say that the photo already looks good, it does not need any editing, then why should I edit the photo? Well, you should edit the photo because it makes it look even better. It adds an extra dimension to the photo and it looks pleasing to the eye. That's why you should always edit your photos, and the best app to edit your photos is Snapseed. Snapseed by Google is by far the best app available right now to edit your photos. It is available on iOS, Android. I have been using it for a very long time. Almost all the YouTubers out there do use Snapseed, and it is a very good app. It is free of cost and you should use it. So right now I'm going to take a photo from my camera, that is my DSLR, and I'm going to edit it in Snapseed. I took the photo today, you saw in the intro, I went to a cafe, I took the photo over there, and let's edit that in Snapseed so that I can show you guys a little bit about how I edit my photos and how I upload them on Instagram. So let me just start the screen recording over here. And by the way, I'm doing this on my Redmi 5. So no matter which device you have, you can use Snapseed. It works with almost all the phones out there. Some lower end phones might have a problem with it, like it might lag a little bit. But yeah, if this phone costs ₹9,000 and still Snapseed works really fine on this phone, that's why you should use Snapseed. Okay, let me just go ahead and start the screen recording first. Okay, so the screen recording is on, and let me go into Snapseed over here. We go into Snapseed, and as you can see, it says tap anywhere to open a photo. So let's open a photo. Let's go to this. Okay, the folder is already open. Let's see which one do we need. This one right here looks good. Okay, So this photo, let's go ahead and edit the photo quickly. Let's go into tools, tune image, bring down the brightness to around 37, or maybe in this lesser 25. Okay, contrast, I need a lot of contrast, so around 63 is good. Saturation, I'm going to leave it as it is. Ambience is a very good tool. It makes the photo look really good. It's like a magic tool. So let's just make it to around 40. That looks good. Highlights, I'm going to bring them down. Shadows, I'm going to bring them up. Warmth, I'm going to leave as it is. So as you can see, I'm just doing very light editing over here, nothing heavy. Let's go to details. I'm going to add a little bit of structure as it is a photo of a food item. Structure is important. And I'm going to add a little bit of sharpness. Again, that makes it look really good. That's done. And if you just click over here, you get like a before and after view. So this is before and this is after. So as you can see, it looks much better. Now let me go to white balance, and here I just select the auto white balance. It detects it automatically and it automatically adjusts it. Okay, so white balance is already perfect, so no need to change the white balance. That's awesome. Then let's go to vignette. Let's add a little bit of vignette. 50 is good. Auto brightness 50 is good. So vignette is there. Yeah, that's it. I'm done. That's all I did over there. This was before and this is after. So as you can see, it looks way better after editing the photo. Now me and my couple of friends run an Instagram for food. Like, it is kind of a page where we post photos about food that is called Flavors of Pune. So we upload photos of various restaurants in Pune. If you haven't followed that page yet, then I'll drop a link to that in the description box below. You can go ahead and check it out. I'm uploading this photo to that Instagram profile after this video. That's why please go ahead and check it out, and please follow that page for awesome photos of food. Okay, so as you can see, after editing the photo looks really well. Now if you want, I'll drop a couple of links to some other applications, like some other photo editing applications like Visco, in the description box below. You can go ahead and check them out. Also, if you want to learn about all the tools in Snapseed, then my buddy Dhananjay Bhosle has made a couple of videos on this application. Like, particularly about this application, he has made a couple of videos. I'll link them in the description box below. You can go ahead and watch those videos and you will learn a lot about Snapseed. Literally, like, if you sit for half an hour and watch his videos, you will learn everything about Snapseed. So please go ahead and watch those videos if you want to learn this application. Hence, overall, do make a note that before you upload your photos to Instagram, do edit them and do not use letterboxes. These are the only two tips that I'm going to give you, and your Instagram profile will look much better. May it be any photo, a group photo, a profile photo, or a landscape photo, a portrait photo, whatever it may be, do edit the photo and it will look much better. So anyway, that's it. I'm done. Do let me know how you feel about this video in the comment section down below. If you like this content, then go ahead and smash that like button and also subscribe to the channel. You can follow me on all my social media platforms. All the links, as always, are available in the description box below. My name is Harsh Punjabi. I'll see you guys in the next one.